destruction of the alveolar bone in the periodontal ligament and finally resulting also in tooth loss. As an alternative treatment strategy, an open flap surgery is often applied, which can be very painful to the patients. But in case on an early disease state, it is also possible to regenerate the destructive tissue structures such as the alveolar bone by use of fibrillar hydrogels that are able to mimic the natural extracellular matrix and can be applied by minimal invasive techniques. So our idea will be to create fibrillar hydrogels that are made up by self-assembling peptides. These self-assembling peptides can form better structures as well as higher order structures like fibrils and fibers depending on pH, ionic strength and peptide concentration. Out of the P11 library designed by Egli et al., we selected two unary and two complementary peptide systems. They are reported to be biocompatible, non-cytotoxic and can assemble in an easy and fast way. I demonstrate this here on the P11 28 and 29 system. We were first interested in how these self-assembling peptide sequences will affect also their respective hydrogel properties. So in our first key findings, we identified that the self-assembling peptide sequence have an effect on the network architecture, the surface chemistry and charge, as well as on the stiffness of the self-assembling peptide hydrogels. Based on these findings, we investigate further how periodontal tissue cells, such as the human periodontal ligand fibroblasts and human cavaria osteoblasts, respond to the different self-assembling peptide hydrogels. Cells cultured on self-assembling peptide hydrogels without pre-incubation of fibronectin were really rounded shaped, whereas with pre-incubation of fibronectin, cells showed a stretched actin filament. Further experiments revealed that the surface chemistry regulate the protein adsorption capacity and thus also in turn the cell morphology. Based on these results, we selected P11-4 and P11-8, which show high protein adsorption capacity and spread cell phenotype, and investigate them further regarding the proliferation.